report it to your doctor or to the care provider at the medical station, so that they will look into it as soon as possible. I know pap smears are kind of uncomfortable, like we know women are scared of it, but it can really save your life, because 90% of the cervical cancer can be prevented if it's detected early by pap smears.
Are you saying that pap smears would always detect if there is the formation of cancer cells within the cervical area?
It will definitely show that there is abnormal growing of your cells, and then it can tell you if you need to do any further testing to evaluate that. But the pap smear is definitely the first step into looking into, is there anything abnormal going on? So that's why it's really important, and that's the main, besides your healthy behavior and your like habits, like your daily habits, that is the other way to really screen for cervical cancer.
Sarah, you talked about some behaviors that are linked to cervical cancer. Do you see how with the connection to sexual behaviors, do you see how stigma can now affect people's responses in terms of do I see something abnormal? Do I go and get diagnosed or go get a pap smear? Because if my behavior is linked to cervical cancer, there is the stigma that is attached to that, and it may actually serve as a deterrent for some people.
I think that although there is a stigma attached, I think the large population of people should be getting their pap smears done regardless. If you're looking into specific stigmas associated with any kind of cancer, people can be judged of different things. So I don't think that it should be necessarily a deterrent to getting your pap smear done. You're still wanting to increase your health in any way you possibly can. And healthcare providers should be able to remain, you know, unbiased in that regard as well.
You're absolutely right, because I was reading a study somewhere about HPV. And in fact, in the United States, it is such a common thing that there is actually what you may call
a
it
vaccine?
A vaccine.
There is.
And they say, I think it was one in every five person comes down with HPV. So it's a very, very, very common thing.
It's very common. Even if you weren't participating in risky sexual behaviors, it's still something that you should be doing because of that point you just mentioned, that it is so common.
And it happens, like, and HPV is a virus, that the human papilloma virus is a virus that is dormant. So you might not be involved in risky behavior, like she says, but you might have caught it along the way of your normal, you know, sexual practice. You never know, you can have it for a long time, and then one day. You have
so there may not be symptoms.
There may not there be. May yeah, not you can say. Yeah, you can say without symptoms
That's
for a long time.
So important to get your screenings done, just because if you don't have any symptoms, you may not know, and that can actually increase your risk of developing cervical cancer.
So in other words, there can be no, and I'm repeating this for the sake of our viewers, there could be no symptoms associated with HPV. On the other hand, HPV is highly contagious. So there's no need for stigma or anything. It is something that someone can come in contact with once you are sexually active. In fact, I've even heard, because of its level of contagiousness, that people who have caught it without even having sexual activity, as in exchange of underclothes and that type of thing. So it confirms here that getting your pap smear is important.
Yes.
It's important.
Very important.
Important for everybody.
Everybody.
Yes.
Very nice. Very nice. In terms of the development of breast cancer and cervical cancers, how can we prevent that? Is there anything we can do to prevent that?
Absolutely. I think the first thing that we should be doing is looking at everyday behaviors that can influence our health outcomes. So very simple things like just being aware of your family history. So talking to your mother, talking to your grandmother, talking to your cousins, and being aware if those cancers are part of your family history. I know my personal family history, my grandmother had breast cancer. She actually had to have a mastectomy to remove tissue. And so that's something I always need to be aware of, as well as my mother and my sisters need to be aware of, because it was common in our family.
Would you use that that process? I don't remember the name now, but that procedure where they actually remove the breast
The
tissue and
mastectomy?
what do you call it?
Mastectomy?
Mastectomy and put implants.
No, I wouldn't go that far.
There was a celebrity that did that recently.
Yes. Angelina Jolie.
Angelina,
yes. To prevent having. She did it as a prevention measure.
Yeah, because I know my history. Yeah?
But there's other things you can do. That's a very severe way to avoid it. But there's very simple things like just being aware of, you know, risk factors such as smoking, such as large quantities of alcohol intake, your diet, your exercise. All of those things can have an influence on your health and the development of cancer, actually. So you want to be aware of those behaviors you participate in.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for that. Ghislaine. And I hope I got that correct. I keep saying
yeah, that's close enough.
you'll work with that.
Yes, I will work with it. That's close enough.
From Cameroon, we'll work with that.
Yes.
In terms of screening in Grenada, what's available for women in terms of screening here?
Yes, so Grenada has many resources. You have the medical stations where you can get a clinical manual breast exam done, and also at the health centers. But you definitely also have Grenada Planned Parenthood that does pap smears for at a cheap cost, but your medical station also provide pap smears, the health center also provide pap smears. Anytime you go to see a doctor, you can ask for more information about it, if they can provide help for you at that moment or anything like that. So definitely really use the resources available at your medical station, the health centers, and through Grenada Planned Parenthood. So self-breast exam, clinical manual breast exams, mammograms done at the health centers, and then pap smears.
Thank you so much for that, folks. We are out of time. So okay. I will give you a minute to wrap things up. If there is any particular message that you'd like to share with all of you in public, then do that. Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess I would like to say in conclusion that we just really would hope that the message taken home today is the importance in screening and being aware of changes in your own body and being aware of talking to those health professionals, doctors, nurses. They're there to help you and to help us understand what's happening and to decrease the rates of cancer in Grenada. We also created a website, so it's easy to access information. So there's lots of different links to Facebook pages and videos that can show the importance and techniques on self-screening. So I guess I'll read it. It's sites.google.com/site/screen GDA.
All right. Could you hold that up and turn it to the camera? Let's get a close-up on that. Yes, that's right. So it's sites.google.com/site/screen GDA. And I'm sure they'll remember that.
Yes, I really hope so.
Right.
And then, yeah, and then also the Grenada Planned Parenthood has a Facebook page. So if people want to go to on Facebook and look for Grenada Planned Parenthood Association.
Right, and that website is going to be listed on there.
Yes. Not on the Grenada Planned Parenthood is listed on this website.
Ah.
But then,
well, you got to get the
exact.
You see,
you have
the
it
other
all.
Way around. Folks, I have just been speaking here, Mara and Ghislaine, and they are from the St. George's University, and we are so grateful that they took the time to come here and talk to us and build our awareness. And I know you've been getting a lot of information left, right, and center. You're literally bombarded, but it's about taking action, and it's never too much information. We want you to literally take action. When is the last time you got a pap smear? When is the last time you did a breast self-examination, right? So unless action, you have not heard it enough. So we're going to keep pounding it home. All right, let's take a break here on Spice Morning. When we come back, we're going to be talking to Senator Sheldon Scott, and it's all about the HYPE program, helping young people excel. We'll be right back.
Sometimes, the simplest joys in life can be the most rewarding. For for quality sexual and reproductive healthcare services, make the GPPA your next stop. Visit our offices at St. George's and Grenville. Call 440-3341 or 425-4442 for more information. The Grenada Planned Parenthood Association, promoting healthy living.
Welcome back to Spice Morning for today, Tuesday, the 8th day of October. Well, before the break, I did say to you that Senator Sheldon Scott and Mr. Earl Williams would be here to talk to us about hype. Well, they are here. Good morning, Senator.
Good morning, Mr. Williams. Good morning.
How are you guys doing today?
I am doing okay.
You all look happy?
Yes,
smiling
quite fine.
And all
that. When I see you, I must smile.
Yeah, oh, goodness, but full of charm. Last night you were on which program?
Watchdog. Yes, I was on the Watchdog program.
Oh, my goodness. As usual, you gave an excellent account of yourself, man.
But I like to be challenged.
You like to be challenged. Now, these guys could be challenging at times. Eh? Well, unfortunately, you don't find that kind of challenge here with me.
No, well, nah, I do get challenged. It's not as easy as people may think it is to come on this.
I hear you. Anyways, HYPE, the acronym, it stands for Helping Young People Excel. Give us a brief background of what HYPE is all about, Mr. Williams.
Yes, definitely. Okay, well, HYPE, as we say, it's an acronym, meaning Helping Young People Excel. It's a program designed under the Rehabilitation Division of the Ministry of Youth. And that program is designed for students at the secondary school level. All right, it's a program designed really as a proactive strategy to help combat youth violence, to assist young people in decision making and choices. In fact, the HYPE program is going to start on Thursday. The first program will be held at the Happy Hill Secondary School. And as we go on, I'll give you a breakdown as to the other programs and what happened.
Okay, I want to know about the format of HYPE. I want to know about the thinking behind HYPE.
It comes out of a program that we had before called Visits to Schools, where she would go around to the different schools and so. And in the previous incarnation of the New National Party administration, Minister Pear would go around to various schools around the island from time to time, secondary schools, primary schools, etc. Many young persons now would remember interacting with the minister at some of these sessions where she would put forth a positive message to the young people and also entertain questions from these young people as to what is going on with them and so on. In many instances, this information has been used to develop the programs that we have within the ministry. The same I meet with young persons on the block. Now, consultation is very important, especially when you're in the context of having a full majority. Well, not just a majority, you have all in the lower house of parliament. Consultation is very, very important. And when we look at the way that young persons became involved in the entire process the last time around, you have to include them now in the process of how you develop the nation as well. So while you would go onto the blocks and you would meet with the young men there, while you would go into different communities and business places and so on, you would meet with young people there. And you would have constituency forums and different things like that that people in. It's also important that we hear from the younger ones, those in the school system as well, that we hear from them, that we interact with them. But at the same time, that we also find a forum to provide them with information as to what the ministry is doing, that you also find a forum to give them information in relation to different things that are happening, youth violence, which is something that's happening right now. We've seen murders this year, we've seen that, and year after year we see these things happening, we continue to cry about it, and then 2 weeks after we forget it. No, we have to address this before it happens. So this is part of what we're going to be doing, because this is part of a wider program called the Youth Rehabilitation Program. So we're going to be speaking to them. We're going to be providing information to them on various things. It could be that we're going to be having, because we will be having some young men who have been involved in youth violence and who have reformed their lives. they are going to be there to speak to the young people and interact with the young people so they can learn from people who've experienced it, who have been there, them, so that they would know how to deal with these issues.
Mm-hmm. Senator, I'm sitting here and I'm almost smiling to myself. In fact, yesterday I had Mr. Chester Humphrey on this program, and one of the comments he made is about how proactive this administration is. And I'm thinking here that the students at the secondary institutions are some of the brightest minds. Okay.